So today we will be diving into Amie. It's a calendar application with a lot of interesting elements to it. It's got an email, it's got a to-do experience, it's got consolidation and much more. We're going to explore it, see whether it's right for you, give you everything you need to know about it in terms of a tutorial and beginner's guide to it, so you can make the decision if this is one for you. Now, you can find Amie linked up here or just below if you're interested, or if you're hunting for calendar applications in general, jump over to Toolfinder. So here we are with Amie, and a lot's changed since I last reviewed it. Some AI abilities, better widgets, and also just, I guess, polishing around the edges. But as you can see here, this is the core experience, and this is available on Mac and a couple of other devices. Let's start with the calendar experience. And as you can see, I can scrabble through my calendar, create events very fast. And what I love about this is how fast the events pop up down here at the bottom. You can go ahead and add guests and also connect up with the likes of Google Meet and other platforms as well. But as you can see, there's also some great sort of little time savers here, like what list you want this part of. And you can see I've got a few lists like calendar, email, and other, which are all connected to emails that are part of my other account. Now I can hide details, pop it up, and it all comes as a fairly nice animation inside of Amie, which makes it definitely playful. Now, if you've not tried the mobile application out, it's very fast, but it also has some really nice gestures and animations to get you going. So I can go ahead and add an event in here like meeting with Bob, and if I press enter, it's gonna go ahead and create that. Now, if I click into it, it instantly pops up with what was before, and I can do a few additional things like duplicate, copy, and delete the item. Now, if I wish to, I can drag it across the calendar as well. Now, obviously, one of the things you can do inside of here is customize it slightly. So you may notice I'm in week view. I can go in visible day view, which I like 3-day view, weirdly. I'm a very strange person. But you can also zoom out as well, which is quite nice. It changes the aspect ratio of your calendar. You can also align it with today in view. So for example, if you're constantly wanting that to appear, then it will fixate it, almost like filling cells inside of a spreadsheet. Now, obviously you may notice a few things that you're probably like, what are these, Francesco? Now, up in the top right-hand corner, you can go meet somebody. And this is if you've got a colleague that you commonly work with. These are all keepproductive.com URLs, which will help me to meet anybody in the team quite easily. And I can also see the calendars that are connected to my main email address. I can also share a booking link up here as well. So if I wanted to just recommend a few times, it comes up as this little gray area, meeting with Francesco, and I can edit some of the details here if I want to add a few more informations to it. I can also add 45 minutes and go ahead and create. In this case, I don't really need to have a meeting tomorrow. Now, you're probably wondering, what are these green things here? Well, crazily, this is your Spotify account. I think this is a useless feature, but some people do like it. I would love to see one of this for like Netflix or what shows did you watch one day, because my wife thinks that she saw a show and we have seen that show, and I can prove it to her now using something like this if they had it. But it's a looking neat little feature to see what songs you were listening to on that given day. Now down here, you're probably seeing, okay, this is a lovely widget for the weather, which is very nice. And you can access the widget here and remove it from the dock if you don't find it suitable. And it's just a nice little way to see, oh goodness, the temperature's just gone up. Fantastic. And you can also see the timer as well, which you can start. And obviously the timer begins within the calendar too. A very interactive experience, which allows you to set a timer and potentially just do a Pomodoro cycle. A lot of people might like that, but you can pause it, play it, and when it's done, you can change it to a set specific time and press play, and you can start to see it pouring out. And as you can see, it changes the amount of time in there. Now, there are some new features with AI scheduling, but I'm going to show you the settings area, or actually I'm going to show you the inbox area, and then I'm going to show you the settings area after. So this is the split view. So you can see on your left, the inbox items that you do have for tasks. And these are obviously brought in from my Todoist account, which is really cool. And that's instantly set up, which is nice. And also I can show weekends. I always forget about that. So that's maybe a nice feature that you do want. And it can even just go to a sole inbox view as well, which is a little bit easier. But in this case, I can even go to my inbox, my work inbox, and see all of the emails that I'm sending as well. And I can even schedule them for appear. So this is almost an email client within the experience too. So if I want to compose an email, I can. And they've got this really nice thing here, which I will show you about it in a moment, but I can send an email to anyone from this as my little sort of Gmail extension. Now I can go here and I can set things like priority levels, super priority being ones that might come into your system, scheduling being basically snooze, and even other stuff like move it to a certain type of folder. So if I go to discard and say I was having a conversation loop, let's just go with this one, open it up if I can. Oh no, this is a task, that's why it's not doing it. If I scrub over to email, then let me open something that I've had a conversation with. So here you can start to see the conversation history with, as you can see, it's starting to give me a timeline of events. And I think that's a really nice feature inside the email extension. But you can see also the attachments and quickly open them as well. I won't go through the email, but you can scrubble through it, which is really nice, and quickly do that. But email is a really neat feature. You can also do things like change color, what calendar it appears in, and you can even drag emails into your system as well, which helps you to organize things ahead. Now, if I was trying to be a little bit more organized, I could add a to-do up here like meet with Bob notes, and you can see that that comes through here. I could even start a timer in my calendar for it, but I can even give it a priority rating too, which helps me to organize it. And I can drag it into my calendar and I can start to see the event appear here and allow me to start working on the item. So there you go. You can see it scheduled into your calendar. You can change the priority levels. You can move it into a set location like today, and that moves out of the area. I didn't know that. But if I go over to today, it should start to see my upcoming list of tasks inside of Todoist because it's bringing in a few items. Now there's quite a lot going on here because you've got your email, you've got your tasks, you've even got calendar lists as well, which you can organize and break everything down into lists, etc., etc. But it's quite extensive in terms of what offering they do have for tasks, because if I go over to settings, I can integrate Todoist so that anything that comes in the Todoist inbox goes inside of the amie inbox, and I can even set it so it's synchronized between the two. But I can go back to integrations and do the same with other applications like Notion, TickTick, Things 3, Linear, and even Zoom as well, which means you can create the video calls like I did with Google Meet earlier. So it's a very interesting setup. So they do seemingly have plans in the future to do things like habit tracking and also the likes of Netflix integration, which I would love, and ClickUp. But you have to sort of request this to give an indication to the team that you want this. Now, this is part of the pro pricing because you get unlimited integrations. I believe in the free plan, you do get restricted to, I think it's something like free integrations, which technically I'm still under. Let's see. There we go. So you get the calendar and to-dos and the three integrations, but you can see here unlimited integrations comes in there and AI auto scheduling and email. So I've obviously accessing email, which is the premium experience. And you can see some of the other benefits like the merch, which is actually very good. I got a hoodie a couple of years ago when they were originally kicking things off, and the hoodie was really awesome. Hoodies, productivity apps. But you can see here, you can change some of the general settings as well, like what your typical duration is and even enabling work hours. But there's also your calendar setups and what you want to view here, as well as your lists and emails and where they come in, what splits into different areas, as well as meetings as well. I usually use Google Meet, so it does save me a bit of time there. So if I go to accounts, I can see what accounts I have switched on, what accounts I have switched off, and you can bring in multiple accounts, I believe in the paid plan, and you can change your profile information. And if I come out of this, you can start to see that obviously your account, that's still going. Obviously it's quite customizable, but there is a new AI scheduling feature, which is part of the premium. They say it's an alpha, not beta, meaning it's very early days, but of course could be one for organizing ahead. So if I was to say design landing page, so this could be for creating to-dos and creating events. So if I was like meet with Bob on Tuesday at 2 p.m. and what it's obviously going to do, likely, there we go. So it's obviously in a very early version of alpha, but assumingly it's super early and uses OpenAI, and there we go. So obviously that's one thing. Maybe I'll try work on new project. That's maybe not a very prompted to do, but there you go. It's very early days, but assumingly this is going to help you to organize what your day ahead is going to look like with some tasks and scheduling. This feature is likely going to resemble what Mady were trying to build with their AI in terms of having a little assistant where you can just talk to it about what's planned for your calendar. So that could be very interesting tool. Obviously in this review, something that you shouldn't look as a feature because it's not fully available yet, but an interesting option. There's also a really nice setup here for for opening up your events, and you can see all of your upcoming events, but you can also see the weather as well and start to organize ahead. Here you can scrubble to the next week, and one final thing, you can go into week view, you can go into month view if you want to, and you can start to see your full month ahead. So largely, this is a very interesting application, and who I would probably recommend it best for is for those who want a light task management system with alongside their calendar, but also that clean structure. This is a fast app, works well, and it's reliable. That's good news. But there are some pro features I think people would like these widgets, and also inside the settings, the customization that you have, including the likes of appearance and lists for organizing your tasks. Now, the integrations are very minimal at the moment, but if you're a Notion user, a Linear user, even TickTick, I think this offering is quite a good one in terms of bringing stuff into one location. So again, if you are in the hunt for a calendar application, a really interesting all-rounder that's doing quite the package of other experiences. I personally don't believe the email package is that compelling inside of a calendar / to-do app, but largely I think it's an interesting option to have, and it shows that the team are progressing well with an interesting set of tools. So that's my take on Amie. I hope it gave you a guide to exploring it and seeing whether it's right for you. Please do check out the links here if you do want to check them out. And of course, I'll see you in a future video, so do make sure to subscribe. I'll see you all very soon, folks. Have a great day. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, you can check out another video here on YouTube diving into productivity tools. But if you did want to, you can jump over to Toolfinder to discover any productivity tools, which will be linked here as well. We have a resource of over 250 productivity tools and growing, and naturally there are reviews, insights, and much more. So do check it out below. But thank you very much for watching this video.